You're ready to start your second project. I'm going to give you three lectures on your project. The first lecture is this one. It will be about the theoretical background of the project of computing the Feigenbaum Delta. The second lecture will go into the nuts and bolts of the algorithm that you'll use to compute the Feigenbaum Delta. And in the third lecture, then, I want to kind of outline the MATLAB code that implements the algorithm. So we're going to go back to the logistic map. Remember, the logistic map is this x sub I plus 1 equals mu times x sub I times 1 minus x sub I. A very simple equation that has very complicated dynamics, as you saw when you computed the bifurcation diagram from this map. We're going to look at the earlier stages in the bifurcation diagram. If you remember, your bifurcation diagram was a plot of the iterates of the map after a transient versus the value of mu, which is the parameter. And when mu was small, the map had a fixed point, so there was only one value of x that kept repeating itself. And then you ended up with a bifurcation. So the bifurcation at some value of mu ended up looking like this, right? So now the meaning of the graph at the bifurcation diagram at this value of mu was that after the transient behavior was gone, you would end up iterating between two values of x. So let's say x naught, x1, x naught, x1. So when you plug in x naught here, you get x1. When you plug in x1, you get x naught. Then as mu increased further, you got another bifurcation where it looked like this. And that's called a period four cycle. So a period one cycle is the fixed point. A period two cycle are two values, x naught and x1, say. A period four cycle are four values, x naught, x1, x2, x3. And then when you plug in x3, you get x naught again. So that's a period four cycle. And then another bifurcation point. So it looks something like this. And that would be a period eight cycle, okay? So each of these had some value of mu. So this one occurred at some value of mu. I'm gonna call that value mu zero. This one occurred at another value of mu. We can call that one mu one. The next bifurcation occurred at mu two, and so on, until you end up with what is essentially an infinite period solution, which gives you chaos. This is called the period doubling route to chaos. Okay. So what is the definition of the Feigenbaum delta then? So if we look at these widths, they're getting smaller and smaller as we get to higher and higher periods. The Feigenbaum delta is equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of these widths. So it's the larger width divided by the smaller width that's right next to it. So we can write that as mu n minus 1 minus mu n minus 2 divided by mu n minus mu n minus 1, okay? How am I labeling these, right? So our n then is the mu sub n here is the bifurcation value of mu when we go from, so mu zero is going from period one to period two. So we go from period two to the n to period two to the n plus one, right? So mu zero goes from period two to the zero, which is one, to period two, mu1 then goes from period 2 to period 4. Okay, that's our definition. Okay, so we could try an algorithm that tries to compute these mu's, but this will be a problem because the transient is extremely long. Okay, right at the bifurcation points, it takes very many iterates of the logistic map to get rid of the transient. So instead of computing at the bifurcation points, we're going to compute at a different value where the cycle is called superstable. So let me discuss how do we define that value. First, I should define what is an orbit of the map. So an orbit of the map, first the period, we're going to define capital N as 2 to the n, so I don't have to keep writing 2 to the n. Then an orbit are these iterates, okay? So an orbit will be x0 after the transient. X0 will give us x1, so when we plug in x0 on the right-hand side, we get x1. We plug in x1, we get x2, and so on. So we're at period capital N, so we have exactly n distinct values here. So we have an x sub capital N minus 1, because we start at 0. This is the orbit, because after this value of x sub capital N minus 1, we end up back again with x0. Okay, so it will repeat itself. So the first n values of x is called the orbit of the logistic map. And that's the case when you have periodic behavior. Okay, so the superstable cycle, contains x equals 1/2 in the orbit. Okay? So there's a nice theoretical result, which we won't go into here, in that for the superstable cycle, when 1/2 is in the orbit, the convergence to the cycle is as fast as possible. So that means the transient behavior is very short. You need very few iterations to get past the transient behavior. That will be very useful, super useful, because the computation will be so much faster. So what does it mean that x equals 1/2 is in the orbit, right? So that means there's some value of x that clips every one of these curves. So say, I'm just making this up, but say here, 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 and all of them, et cetera, right? So every single cycle goes through this value of x, and this value of x is 1/2, okay? Okay, so instead of computing delta at the bifurcation points, what we're going to do is we're going to compute delta by computing, by finding the superstable values, right? By finding the values of mu, where the orbit then contains the superstable point. So I'll just call that x naught, where the orbit contains x naught equals 1/2. Okay? So we're just going to change the definition. It will go to exactly the same number, the Feigenbaum delta, but the computation will be much faster. Okay, so we can't do much analytically here, except find the first two values of mu, where x naught equals 1/2 is in the orbit. We're going to call those values m, so we're going to define m sub n to be the period 2 to the n cycle with x naught equal 1/2 in the orbit. Okay? And we're going to replace mu here in the definition of the Feigenbaum delta by m. Okay? That's what we're going to do. We can compute, say, the first value of m. So if we want to compute m0, right? So m0 means that 1/2 is a fixed point. So if you plug 1/2 in the right-hand side here, you get 1/2. So mu will be m0 when x naught equals 1/2 is a fixed point. So the equation then will be 1/2 is equal to mu, which will be m0 when we solve this, times 1 minus 1/2. Or this is, mu times x, which is 1/2, times 1 minus 1/2. This is 1/2 times 1/2, which is 1/4. You multiply both sides by 4, and we solve for mu. So we get mu is equal to 2, which tells us that our m naught is equal to 2. Okay? So the first value of mu, the first superstable cycle for the period 1 solution, is mu equal to 2. So m naught equals 2. Okay, the best we can do analytically is to find the period 2 value. So that would be m sub 1. So the period 2 value means that we have period 2. So when we plug in x naught, we get x1. So x1 is equal to mu x naught times 1 minus x naught. And then when we plug in x1, we get back x naught. So x naught is equal to mu x1 times 1 minus x1. Okay? The superstable cycle has x naught equal to 1/2. We don't know what the value of x1 is, but we can eliminate x1 from the second equation. So we can use the first equation here and substitute it into the second equation and obtain an equation for x naught. And then we plug in x naught equal to 1/2, right? And then we get an equation for mu. I asked you to do that as a reading problem. What you'll compute is a cubic equation for mu. So mu cubed minus 4 mu squared plus 8 equals 0. So already in the computation of m1, we end up with a cubic equation to solve. You can do this analytically because we know that mu equal to 2 is a solution, right? If x1 was equal to x0, then both of these equations would be satisfied. So then the solution to that is mu equal to 2. So if we plug in mu equal to 2, we have 2 cubed, which is 8, minus 4 times 4, minus 16, plus 8, and that definitely gives us 0. So we can factor out the mu equal to 2 root here doing polynomial division, and you're going to do that as a reading problem, and then what you find then is the solution for mu, which will give us m1, so you will compute that m1 equals 1 plus square root of 5, okay? So to start our numerical method, actually, it will be useful to have these two values in hand. The numerical method we use will be Newton's method, so we're going to need some good guesses for these values of m, m sub n, as n becomes large, okay? So this is kind of the whole theoretical background. We started our computation. We only did two values because that's all we can do by hand. And then the numerical work will then start by computing M2, and then M3, M4, M5, M6, all the way into the teens. Already 2 to the 10th is 1,024. So we're going to have very high period solutions. Let me review. This is the first video of 3 discussing your second project. You're going to go back to the logistic map and the bifurcation diagram. And now we're going to compute a number that's very special called the Feigenbaum Delta. That shows us a number which characterizes what's called the period doubling route to chaos. It shows up in many nonlinear systems, not just the logistic map, but perhaps this is the absolute simplest system where it shows up and enables us to calculate the value. We define it as the way that the widths of these mu widths decrease as the period becomes larger and larger, okay? So that eventually you converge to some value of mu, some finite value of mu, where the map becomes chaotic. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.